introduce about myself. My name is Tan. I am currently an iOS developer at Rakuten BT. So to find more information about me, you can visit my LinkedIn homepage. And if you have any question, please don't hesitate to send a message to my Gmail. So for us here, we are engineering, and our mission is to bring the best experience to customers. But because the resource we have is limited, hence whenever we want to implement anything, we always need to consider between the cost and the profit it can bring to us. So today in my presentation, I would like to share with you one solution which doesn't cost you too much but can help your service reach out a lot of more users. And you know, the more users, the more profitable. And the topic I want to bring to you today is about developing for Apple TV. For the agenda, I want to break my talk into three separate sections. First is about Apple TV and tvOS, and then I will give you some fundamental things when we work with Apple TV. And finally, I will show you how things work in reality with a real demo. So okay, let's start with Apple TV and tvOS overview. Apple TV is a digital media player device. It can collect data from internet, and to use it for viewing, you have to connect it with the TV by a HDMI cable. So on the screen, I have the latest Apple TV, the Apple TV 4K. And stand next to it is a Siri remote, which you need to use it to control the Apple TV. Furthermore, you also can use your iPhone to communicate with Apple TV. I think for me, this is something very awesome from Apple. Everything can be compatible together perfectly. So I have a little fun fact about Apple TV. You know, even though Apple TV only have 5 models, but it's actually older than the iPhone. The first Apple TV was launched in 2006, and interestingly, at this time, it still runs on Mac OS. Until 2010, Apple redesigned the Apple TV and made the second generation run on tvOS 9, which they said that 95% based on iOS 9. You know, originally, I thought that Apple TV is only applicable for video or gaming app. But in fact, there are many more kinds of apps on Apple TV further than that. For example, do you think that you can book a hotel from a TV? The answer is yes, because Airbnb gives you that option. So actually, I think for me in some situation, Apple TV would be a better solution than the iPhone. Because, for example, imagine that we are planning for a vacation with our family. It's better if we can sit down and book the hotel together, right? In this case, Apple TV would be a better solution for the discussion because everyone can see the hotel picture on the shared TV, and with the big picture, it also look more attractive and make you more desire to book the hotel. So compare with their rival who doesn't have an Apple TV app, they're losing this huge number of users. And besides Airbnb, a lot of other services also support for Apple TV. For example, on the screen I have Amazon, an e-commerce service, they also allow you shopping online through Apple TV. Or Tinder, a social network application is another example. So actually, Apple TV apps are very diverse, not only for video or gaming. Therefore, I think you can also find a way to implement your own one. In my perspective, I think creativity has no limit. As long as you intend to have one, you could find a way to do it. And here I have a chart for Apple TV turnover from 2012 to 2017. Apparently, Apple TV is growing up very fast. Like in 2012, there are 4.2 million devices has been sold, and that number has increased by 6 times to 25 million after 3 years. And in 2017, it reached 75 million, which is 3 times better than in 2015. So actually, I can say that 75 million is a very huge number because Apple TV is not an individual device. Usually, we only have one per family. And you know, right now with 75 million, Apple TV is the second largest TV box brand in the world. This is very impressive, right? And you can keep in mind that people who willingly spend money to buy an Apple TV for entertainment, they are very potential to buy for your service as well. So I think if you want to expand the market, it's obviously a good solution for you. Okay, we'll continue with some fundamental things when working with Apple TV. So Apple provides to you two types of Apple TV app, and in general, we will make them in different way. So the first is a custom app which you develop is similarly when you do on iOS. It's using the same framework and the same concept you may already know about UIKit, Auto Layout, or Storyboard. And the second one is client server app, which you need to use TVML, TVGS, and TVMLKit to make it. So okay, we'll explain for you these three abbreviations. TVM stands for Television Markup Language. This is a kind of XML and a kind of markup language. In a few slides, I will show you some examples about TVML. TVGS stands for Television JavaScript. This is a set of JavaScript API which provides to you the means to display any app created by TVML. And TVMLKit is a framework which helps you be able to communicate between TVOS native code and TVML JavaScript code. So how does a TVMLKit app work? So different with the custom app, the TVMLKit app is based on client-server architecture. So here the client will be the UIKit-based app. It runs on the TVOS device. And the server will host the JavaScript files and media contents. So when the app launch, it will download JavaScript file, also set up JavaScript environment, and hand over the control to JavaScript. So once the control is handed over, JavaScript will be responsible to download any additional content that it needs to present to its users. So to make it easier to make a TVML app, Apple provides a dozens of TVML pre-made template, which you can trust you to display information in a specific way. So I will give you some example, and I will start with a simple one first. So here on the screen, I have an image of the alert view on Apple TV, and next to it is a pre-made template diagram. I think it's not too hard for you to mapping between each element from the diagram to the one on the view. And here is how the TVML code look like. I think if you have used any markup language before, such as XML or HTML, you could be very familiar with this format. And each field on this template code is just mapping one-on-one to an element from the diagram. And finally, after you filling up with the data, you will have the view as expectation. And let me assure you that this is not a web browser. It's completely native. And we're just done with the very simple one of TVML example. Here I have another one for a more complex layout. You can see it's the very long page and the layout is also very complicated. But Apple also gives you a template for this. And here's how the template look like. Again, it's very clear and easy to translate between each item from the diagram to the one on the view. And after all, I have a template code. So you can just, based on this template code, to key in any data you want to display, and TVMLKit will take care of the rest for you. You don't need to worry about the layout anymore, but TVML will do it for you. So I make a simple comparison between working with the custom app versus with TVML app. So for custom app, you will develop it similarly when we do on iOS and using Swift or Objective-C. Whereas for TVML app, you need to use TVML, TVGS, and TVMLKit with JavaScript. So the custom app will take you more effort for creating, but it is scalable in long term. And this is very suitable if your app has customizing design. On the other hand, TVML app will take you less effort at the beginning, but it's not so scalable in the long term. And it's also appropriate if your app has a similar design with Apple template layout. So depending on your purpose, I think you would find the most suitable way to implement your Apple TV app. But for us here in Wiki, we have implemented our Apple TV app in both ways. And with our experience, I would recommend you to use the custom app instead. Because first, we already have an iOS project which has a lot of similar features that we may have on Apple TV. And by using custom app, you can reuse a lot of code that makers can, you know, maintain and scale both apps together. And secondly, If you choose TVML app, it will take you more time to ramp up with TVML because this is a new concept. And for those who hasn't worked with JavaScript before, I think it will be also more time consuming to get used to it. And in my opinion, honestly, I'm much more comfortable to work on Swift more than on JavaScript. Because I got used to Swift or Objective-C when I work with iOS. And also for Swift and Objective-C, I can easily use the breakpoint in Xcode. It's very useful when I want to debug. But on JavaScript, you don't have it. If you want to use breakpoint, it will be very hard to set it up. And also, one line on JavaScript is very long and very hard for us to observe the breakpoint. So therefore, I will continue with developing the custom Apple TV app on an existing iOS project. So our object is to build an Apple TV app with the least cost, and assuming that we already have an iOS native project, let's see what we can take advantage for tvOS. So basically, for any iOS project, we can split it into four different layers. At the bottom, I have core framework and third-party libraries, which we use as an ingredient to make our own app. And then I have a next layer for business logic. Generally, this layer is for non-UI code. And in this layer, it will offer you some services we will use in app, like API service, or payment service, or deep link handler, etc. And the top layer is a UI layer, is particularly for UI code. So let's see with this structure what we can reuse for tvOS. So as I said before, because tvOS is very close to iOS, that's why most of the core framework and third-party libraries on iOS, they are also available on tvOS. For instance, I have iXSwift, React Native, Alamo Fire, SwiftJSON, and many other awesome libraries that we are using every day on iOS. They all support for tvOS. So for the next layer, business logic layer, you know, ideally, under the logic for the both platforms, I think we should share it together because its makers can maintain and scale the business. We don't need to like fix or change anything two times if it is the same. And for the top layer, the UI layer, actually we will not reuse much code in this layer, because iOS devices are very different to Apple TV devices. So the layout on iOS also very different to tvOS. Hence, we only need to reuse some of the base class extension. For example, if you have UI label extension or UI button extension, it will be the choice to share on the UI layer. So I really encourage you to isolating the business logic and the UI layer, because it will make our project become more structured, more organized, and more testable. So I have talked about the theory too much. I think now is the time for me to show you a demo to see how it works in reality. So here I have prepared an iOS project. Let me quick run it first to show the demo on iOS device. Okay, here I have a simple sample on iOS 1. Can you see on the screen? Okay, thanks. So on the screen I have an iOS simulator and it has a very simple app. It just has 10 WWDC videos, and when I click on any of them, it will just open the video player page. It has a scrubber bar, or you also can change the subtitle. Okay, this is a very simple one on iOS app. So let's quick look at the project side to get the structure of the app. So here I have a folder which includes all of the resources I will use in app. Inside, I already wrote all of the business logic classes in this folder. It's basically some model declaration or API or view model or data source. And the rest is just for app delegate, view controller, collection view self, some storyboards. I also have another folder for a few unit tests that I have written. So my target right now is to build an Apple TV app on top of this project. To do that, first I need to add the new target. So I just need to click on this plus button here, and I select tvOS, and then select single view app. So wrap next. So I will name it wwdc_tvOS to distinguish with the iOS one. So after I click on the finish button, Xcode will automatically generate for me two new targets here and two new folder here specifically for Apple TV. And if I click on the scheme here, there's also another alternative for me to select. So now I will try to run on Apple TV 4K simulator. I think for some of you guys here, maybe the first time you see Apple TV simulator, right? And yeah, makes sense, right? And here is how it looks like. This is the Apple TV simulator. It's running on tvOS 12. So it is still empty because I didn't add anything into the Apple TV target. So let's try to add some into it. As I said before, this init logic layer, this layer we should share between iOS and tvOS. That's why we move them out of the subfolder and put in the same directory with iOS and tvOS. So now I will try to add them to Apple TV target by select all of them. So you open the sidebar here. To add it, you just need to check on this checkbox. It will add to wwdc_tvOS target. Now we will try to recompile again. Okay, it showed me an error, no such module, switch.json, which means that first, the file was added into Apple TV target successfully, but it won't compile because I didn't add the dependency to tvOS. So now to add it, I just need to change a little bit here. Like, basically, I just copy and paste this and change this to tvOS. This one also needs to change to tvOS. And don't forget to change the test folder as well, test target, sorry. But actually, I am not a fan of repeating the code like that. It makes us hard to maintain in the future. So instead, I write a function for the SharePort. And instead of listing all of the library like this, I can just use this. So imagine that in the future we have 10 or 20 libraries. You don't need to update the version one-on-one between each framework. So now we'll try to run port install. So after it runs successfully, I will try to recompile the project again. Now it still throw me an error, but this is a different one already. So which means the dependency we just recently added is successful. So the new error is because I don't have this video collection view self on Apple TV. So let me open the iOS one for you again. So here I have a class for video collection view self. But as I said, we will not share the UI on iOS and tvOS. That's why I will create another one for this. So I will add the new file. And just reuse the same name with this. Yeah, remember we only need to select one target here. So you see that I have prepared the code for this already. So basically it just has some UI elements and it have layout constraints, and also it will update the information when we have the view model. And I also need to update view controller as well to make it have something to work at the beginning. So let me quick show to you is just have data source declaration and collection view. And in view load, I will add the collection view into the view here. Also, we'll try to fetch some data at the beginning. So now we try to run again. Oh, so right now it's not only can compile, but it shows the data for you already. It's quite simple, right? I didn't do much thing. Just only need to declare some code for the UI, just for the connection view and for the view controller. And now I already have the similar app which I already have on iOS. So it also has 10 video here. And when I click on any of them, it will bring the video player page for me. So in this page, you also can like has a scroll itself. If you want to change the subtitle, it's also support for you. So pretty easy. So I just recently introduced you how easy it is to have an Apple TV app. If you can have an iOS project with a very structure, very organized structure. So, but the current app is only has 10 video. I actually prepare more data than that. The current app only fetch the first page of the JSON I prepare here. So now I will implement another new feature. I call it pagination. So to do that, I just simply add the few lines of code in the data source. So my idea is very simple. When the connection view displays the cell which near the end, I will try to fetch more data as long as we still have data to load. So now we try to recompile again on Apple TV. Okay, now I will try to scrolling more on the right. And you see, it's not only show 10 for me anymore, but instead a lot of more. Until it cannot load more data, it will keep loading and showing to you on the screen. So as I said before, this glass is a shared glass between iOS and tvOS, and I recently updated for tvOS, which means it will have that new feature on iOS as well. So to demonstrate for you, I will try to run it again on the iOS. Okay, now I will try to scrolling more down. Yeah, it showed me more than 10 videos, which means the code we recently added just only in one place, but it affects in both places. Which means in the future, if you want to implement any feature, you can just want to do it once. So the logic code will be shared, and you don't need to re-implement this on tvOS. For example, we recently have the new feature like GDPR that you need to update for all of the products, right? So to do this on the same way like that, you don't need to recombine, you don't need to re-implement this in particular platform. So the last thing I want to share with you is about CI/CD. Actually, it's very important because we are doing both platform in a single project. We need to make sure that all of the change we made for a single project, it won't break anything on the other platform. So here I have prepared a simple fast file, which inside I have a simple land test, which will just run on the unit test that I have written. So to set it up for tvOS, I can again just simply copy and paste from iOS. We need to change it here and also here. But again, repeating the code will make us not easy to maintain in the future. So instead of listing the test length right there, then I will make you another option to do. Okay. So my idea is very simple. So instead of you listing this particular platform for iOS and tvOS, I just make them as the variable, and I will take it from the array here. So because I only support for two platforms right now, iOS and tvOS. So for you, if you want to support more platforms, for example, watchOS or macOS or even Android, you can just use this same format, then it will automatically generate the LAN for you. So finally, how to fire a LAN on tvOS? Basically, when you want to run the LAN test here on iOS, you can just run fastlan. Sorry. That's right. But actually, this is the abbreviation because the 41 would be Fastlane iOS Test. But we declare the default platform as iOS. That's why if we don't give the context for Fastlane, it will pick the default one here to run the test. So you can use this command to run on tvOS by run Fastlane tvOS test. And if you implement the CI and you want to run both LAN in just single command, I have another option here. I create the global LAN here, which the idea is also very simple. It will pick each platform I put here, and we ask Fastlane to fire the LAN, which the name will be similar with the one I put here. Then Fastlane will understand and will fire the LAN you put here for each platform. So the last thing is that if you check the readme.md, this file is automatically generated by Fastlane whenever you run any LAN. It showed me that all of the available action I already have. First is the test on, which will run the test on both platform here. And to fire this, just run Fastlane test on. I also have a particular LAN for iOS and tvOS, and to fire, you can just run Fastlane iOS test or Fastlane tvOS test. Yeah, this is everything I want to share with you in my demo. So let's go back to the slide. I will show you. So to summarize to you, I have 3 points I want to highlight. First, Apple TV is a very potential market. It keeps increasing 100% to 150% year after year. And secondly, Apple TV is adaptable with any kind of business, not only for video or gaming. And finally, building and maintaining Apple TV app doesn't cost you too much, especially if you already have an iOS project. In fact, making the custom Apple TV app will have you a chance to clean up the iOS project, make it more organized, more structured, and more testable. So that's all I want to share with you today. I think it's now time for Q&A.
Thank you everyone who asked questions. Come on.
Let's go.
Oh, yeah.
What's the most challenging thing that you have to do when you build a tvOS app?
Actually, because I built the tvOS app on top of the iOS one. So we want to reuse a lot of code. We want to reuse as much as possible because its makers can scale and maintain, right? So actually the own iOS one, we are missing between UI and logic code. And it's not easy for us to split them out and make them reduce the logic code only. I think this is the most challenging one when I work with Apple TV. But on the other hand, it gives us, make the project more organized, and after that, I also be able to write a lot of unit tests for the app. So it's make it more reliable, actually.
Is the answer okay for you?
Great.
Yes. Any
query here? Sorry. Some of the, you told us that the UI code is not reusable and it's entirely different. But, and if you think that some of it could be, you could use protocols or something like that just to, use the same kind of thing so that it's more usable, and yeah, it's kind of decoupled that way. Does that make sense, or is that practically not viable?
Yeah, actually, I think. This makes sense. So we also have kind of the protocol, but it's basically for the action only. It's not for like the UI itself. Like you cannot. Like just write a lot of protocol to set the size of the label or the size of the image or the color as well. But you can have a protocol, like when you type on the button, right? You can have the protocol to lead both of them go to the same logic code. So it will be a part of logic code. It will not be on the UI anymore. So layout will be very plain, very simple. Just declare the view inside and how to interact with user, and that's all. Thanks.
Anybody else? Okay. No? Victor?
I haven't tried SnapKit, but they said that React Native is available on TVOS, but SnapKit I haven't tried. So yeah, I think I will try and then maybe reply to you later.
All right. Very nice presentation. Okay. Thank you.